Thank you for joining us. In this video, we'll discuss a fast-growing industry in Wisconsin, the mining and processing of frac sand. What it is, where it's found, what it's used for, and how real estate and personal property used in the industry are assessed at the local and state level. What is frac sand? Frac sand is quartz sand of a specific grain size and shape that is suspended in fluid and injected into oil and gas wells under very high pressure. That pressure opens and enlarges fractures. It also creates new ones. The extra strength sand grains are then carried into these fractures, propping them open as the fluid is pumped out. Optimal frac sand is round grain, relatively coarse, and holds up under tremendous pressure. Where is frac sand found? Frac sand is being mined from sandstone formations in much of western and central Wisconsin. In the eastern and southern parts of the state, the same formations are less well exposed and generally more fine-grained. What is frac sand used for? Frac sand is used by the petroleum industry in the oil and natural gas extraction process called hydraulic fracturing, also known as fracking. Assessing real estate and personal property associated with frac sand is a uniquely complex task involving us at the Department of Revenue and you as a municipal assessor. There are two primary considerations for the assessment of sand mines: when the parcels are locally assessed and what triggers a manufacturing assessment at the state level. Individual parcels of land where frac sand is mined may be assessed by us at the Department of Revenue or by you locally, depending on the main use of the land site. Real estate and personal property used by frac sand businesses is assessed by local assessors until we, at the Department of Revenue, classify the business as Class 3 manufacturing. This process of classification is an important first step in assessing the real and personal property. We will classify a frac sand parcel as manufacturing and assess at the state level if the parcel is a mine site with greater than 50% of the overburden removed. Overburden is the topsoil, gravel, rocks, plants, bushes, and trees covering the sand. More than 50% of the parcel must be used directly in the mine site operation, or the real estate parcel has a wet or dry sand processing plant. You will assess the frac sand parcel at the local level if the overburden has not been removed, or less than 50% of the overburden is removed and less than 50% of the parcel is used in mining operations. In this case, you would assess land and improvements locally, and the personal property would be assessed by the Department of Revenue after proper classification. An assessor reviewing frac sand sites should consider several things. First, determine if the frac sand mining is illegal on that parcel. Does the current zoning allow mining? And if not, how likely is it that there's going to be a zoning change? Does the owner have the necessary permits to mine frac sand? And do the permits cover all or part of the parcel? An assessor should also determine where frac sand deposits are distributed within a parcel. It is important to identify areas used in the manufacturing mining operations against the total use of the parcel. Any areas not in agricultural production or those that are forested are not included in the acre base. Next, consider the subject sale as an indicator of value and also consider comparable sales as indicators of value. For property sales, determine if a zoning change or mining permit were contingencies to the contract sale price. Finally, investigate the deed transferring ownership or contact the real property lister in your county to see if large land purchases have multiple legal descriptions. This helps ensure that the department classes and assesses only those parcels engaged in frac sand mining. Now, let's look at an example of frac sand site assessment. Consider this scenario. On February 1, 2011, Company ABC purchased 3 parcels of agricultural land totaling 100 acres from Farmer Jones. Company ABC paid $1 million for 3 parcels of land, 2 40-acre parcels and 1 20-acre parcel. Frac sand deposits extend throughout the entire 100 acres. Company ABC obtained a zoning change to allow mining for all 100 acres and a permit to mine frac sand from the same 100 acres. The company did remove the overburden and mined 25 acres of a 40-acre parcel in May of 2011. The other two parcels, which total 60 acres, are leased back to the farmer to continue in his use in agriculture. In July of 2011, the property owner company ABC requests assessment classification as manufacturing. The Department of Revenue determines that the 40-acre mining site will be assessed as manufacturing property for the January 1, 2012 assessment because it was used as a mining operation as of that date. In 2012, the department will assess the 40 acres of land with mining as a mining operation at fair market value, looking for sales of subject and comparable properties and other evidence of value. There are sales of similar land containing frac sand deposits in the market area that support a unit value sale price of $10,000 per acre. The 2012 state assessment will reflect a similar market value for the 40 acres for an approximate total assessment of $400,000. In 2012, the remaining 60 acres of the sale will be assessed by the municipal assessor. The classification will be determined by the use of the property. In this case, since the farmer is using the land for farming, the classification would be agricultural. The assessor would use the use values for the municipality in determining the assessment of the 60 acres. Now on to personal property. Personal property used by a frac sand business is assessed by us at the state once the business is classified as manufacturing. With this manufacturing distinction, much of the machinery and equipment used in the processing of sand is exempt from taxation. It is important to note that the Department of Revenue cannot retroactively classify a company as manufacturing. If the business is not classified by March 1st of the assessment year, the personal property is assessed at full value by the local assessor. Now let's take a look at some of the manufacturing classified machinery and equipment used in the frac sand extraction and processing. Some of the assets are exempt, while some are taxable. If assessed by the municipal assessor, all the machinery and equipment will be taxable. Mine site. For mine site equipment, exempt items include blasting, crushing, excavation, and screening equipment, while taxable items might include buildings, fuel tanks, loaders, rail spurs, truck scales, and wells. For wet plant equipment, exempt items might include aggregate conditioners, attrition scrubbers, coarse material screw washers and clarifiers, waste treatment equipment, and many others. Taxable items include forklifts, raw material and finished product handling equipment, generators, maintenance equipment, and rail spurs. For dry plant equipment, exempt items include screening and bagging equipment, bucket elevators, in-process conveyors, evaporative cooling equipment, and dust collectors. Taxable items include conveyors to trucks and rails, finished product material handling and storage, fuel tanks, rail spurs, and generators. Equipment leased to a manufacturer is considered taxable to the lessee or manufacturer. The exempt versus taxable status applies to leased equipment as well. We do hope this presentation has helped you better understand frac sand mining and frac sand assessment processes in Wisconsin. Remember that the assessment guidelines are general. If you have questions or concerns about assessment, please contact your local Department of Revenue District Office. For more information, visit our website at revenue.wi.gov. Thank you for watching.